Now let's talk about Scrapy. Scrapy is a framework which will help you extracting the data from websites. But before we can scrap the data from a website, we need a way of informing Scrapy exactly which data do we need. So the first step is always analyze the website that we want to scrape. Now this is a sample website which is actually made to practice scraping. So this is one page which is a random quote. So every time I refresh, one different quote will be shown, but the structure remains same. So let's say that we want to extract the quote, the author, and the tags. So let's say that these are the three information that we want to scrape. So first step, let's go and check the website structure. So right click and inspect. So we can see that this quote text is inside a span. This author is inside a span. And the tags are inside a div. And they have actually individual A tag because they are linking to probably other quotes on the same subject. So now we have two options. Number one, we can use XPath to select a specific element. Or number two, we can use CSS. Now if you are comfortable with XPath, go ahead and use it. They are very powerful and very flexible. But for a newcomer, XPaths can be a little bit daunting. So CSS is a better choice. And in this series, we will be using CSS. So let's start with this one, the text. So if you look at text, let's right click this text, the actual code, and click on inspect. And here we have it. Let's expand it. So this text is inside a span, which is having one class called text and one item prop called text. So this is the attribute name item prop. So this is the attribute value. So we can use any one of these to find the element. Now whether we are able to find the element correctly or not, let's use something called Scrapy Shell. So I'm going to copy this URL, go to command prompt, and I'm going to run pip install Scrapy. And there is one more package that I'm going to install. This is called IPython. Because I already have these packages installed, it doesn't take time. Now let's run the Scrapy command. Scrapy has various commands and one of them is shell. So this is what we are going to use. So shell will give us interactive scraping console. So let's see it in action to understand how it works. Scrapy shell and this URL that we copied. So Scrapy will go and connect to this URL and give us some useful objects. The most important object here is response. So if we just print response, we can see that this is the URL that we have fetched and the response code was 200, which means it was successfully scraped. So 200 is okay, 400 is client error, and 500 is server error. This is how it works. And 300 is redirects. Now if I print response.text, what I will see is the complete HTML of this particular page. So we have the complete HTML. Now what we need to do is we need to locate this particular code. And we saw that the class is text. So let's copy this class. Let me press Ctrl L to clear it up. So we have response.css. And here inside the brackets in the quotes, we can write our CSS selector. So because this is a class, we will have to use a dot, a period. So let's press enter. And we can see that we have a selector object. Now we don't need a selector object. What we need is actual element. Now to get the actual element, we will use get method. So we can see that we have the complete span element. So response.css, this gives selector. response.css.get, this gives specific element. Now what we actually need is the text. So we will use one pseudo element, double colon, text. So this is what we are going to use, and this will return the actual text of the code. So far so good. Let's move on. Now what we need is the author. So right click, inspect, and we have author here, which is a tag called small. It is having one author class and one more attribute called item prop, which equals author. So we can use class or we can use author. So let's try with class. So actually nothing will change if I just repeat the same command and paste in author. There we have it. Now what you see on the page and what you see on this shell is different. We have a different quote here and we have a different quote here, because these two are separate requests, and because quotes are created randomly, you see this different. So here, very easy, we can get author by class. Now what if this class was not there? So we could use another attribute, this item prop. Now item prop, we don't have a specific selector for item prop. So in this case, what we can do is we can use attribute selectors. So response.css and attribute selectors, they use square brackets. In the square brackets, I have simply pasted in the attribute and its value. And now let's call the get method. And we have actually the same text. I'll have to call text, and it has to be outside the square brackets, and we will get the author. So now we have the text actual quote, and we have the author, and two ways to get the author. Finally, it's time to get the tags. So let's see. Right click, inspect, and here we can see that all these tags are contained inside a tag, and they are having a class tag. So this is again straightforward. So we'll say response.css tag text and get. Now there is a problem here. The problem is there are multiple tags and we want all of them. But here we are getting only one. For that, the solution is to call get all method. So there are two methods, get and get all. So if we call get all method, it will return all the elements which are matching this particular CSS selector. So get will return one value, and get all will return all values as a list. Have a look at this square brackets. So if you see square brackets, it's a list. If you see quotes, it's a string. So get returns a string, while getAll returns a list of string. And as you might have guessed, if there are multiple values and you call get method, you will get only the first result. So now that we have all the selectors ready, let's go and create our first Python.